Valiant warrior against the void.
You're good with the Magister's cage in anyone.
Taken too early. All hope destroyed.
Throw him in a hole.
The path thus ended. The conclusion of a noble bloodline.
What's even the point?
This must be the place Lohar mentioned. It looks unassuming enough. Lohar will want to know of this.
You run your hands along the exterior until your fingers graze the button noted in the schematic. There's no mistaking the sound of stone chafing stone. the entrance to the chamber grinds open, filling your lungs with slightly less stale air.
A skull? It's missing an eye. As far as locks go, this one's pretty macabre. A skull? It's missing an eye. As far as locks go, this one's pretty...
The shrine depicts Duna, yet has clearly seen better days. Scratches and fissures, you scrape your knee on the wooden floor. The stone is cold against your palm. There's no mistaking the sound. This shrine to there's no mistaking. Thank you.
useless. Bloody useless.
Might as well have rotted in the death hole. What's he doing?
My friends, for Alexander the Innocent.
A new civil war.
Better get out there before Moldus makes it all the way past Arx. All right. That's right. Lost one of my best lads, Anhar. Didn't get Jalia's body back, though. Maybe one of them beasts took her like they did the sorcerers. Well, I reckon that's good news. Poor thing. She'll be back in time. She and Anhar were sweethearts. Bloody lad. Flapping his gums in the next life, too. That's another little venture of ours. Don't concern you, though. We will, once the Reds turn down the alarm a bit. They're jumpy as all hell for the moment. Won't do anyone any good to raise a ruckus now. Don't insult me. I wouldn't expose my people like that. But if you find out who did it, shake their hand for me. Whatever needs doing. Isn't that obvious?
You ain't gonna last much longer.
Looking rough, Mole. Real rough.
Better get out there before Molt, all right?
That's a lot of blood.
Think those fingers of yours will ever heal? Lot of blood.
you got to make us hurt you?
Think those fingers of yours will ever heal?
This is going nowhere.
I'm telling you, if you got nothing to hide, they got nothing to be scared of.
Yeah, you're good with the
magic. Wait, my friend, for Alexander the Innocent.
Stew is good, if you're thinking of eating.
Sorcerers, a most vile incident.
Not right now.
A valiant warrior against the void.
On the arse.
Better get out there before Maldus makes it all the way past Ark. I asked you for a man, not a note.
He takes the letter from your hands and reads it quickly, face hardening with anger as he reaches the end.
Bloody goddamn spit-sucking weasel! This is bad. Not just for me and mine. Not just for you and yours. This is bad. For everyone. Hell if I know, but it don't sound good. Seems as though Maldus wasn't mine after all. Trouble is, I don't know whose he is. Of course. That's why I haven't heard from the cave. Sabotage. Listen up, I need your help. We all do. Maldus has his hands on something dangerous. Something I was trying to protect us from. Not just my folks, the whole damn realm. Look, me and mine, we move classified cargo. Take it right off Magister ships and put it into the hands of those that will use it rightly. Trouble is, we came across something no one ought to have. Not the Magisters, not my folks, not the gods themselves. I ordered it to be destroyed. I guess Mordus, whoever he's working for, wants it for themselves. That can't happen. The less you know, the better. Trust me. Stop Mordus and I'll take care of the rest. My people had an operation up in the caves outside town. Good access to red ships and plenty of privacy too. Haven't heard from them in a couple of days now. I thought maybe we'd lost the messengers to Voidwoken in the hills, but now I think it's worse than I thought. I bet my lucky left foot Mordus is in the cave. You gotta get to him before he gets his hands on that cargo. Pray to whoever you pray to that it ain't too late. Finally, someone with a little sense around here. Give me your map. I'll show you where we were operating, where I think Mordus will be. I don't want to know what'll happen if he gets what he's after.
Tears when weeping comes. Who shall
Sighting a stocky paladin seated ahead, Ifan tugs at your sleeve.
This one I remember. Hardwin and I served together back in the war. Let me do the talking.
The two men embrace, amicably enough, but you sense an uneasy tension running beneath their smiles.
Well, as I live and scarcely breathe, if it isn't Ifan Benmezd. I thought you died in the death fog. Thought you died a hero. But I suppose it's better to live as one. We really gave those Black Ring what for, eh? Wiped them all out in the blink of an eye. Damned proud to have served with you, Benmezda. Damned proud.
Ifan's face turns sour as he mutters something under his breath that only the paladin can hear. Hardwin loses all camaraderie and blanches, stepping backwards. He puts one hand on his weapon.
You've changed, and for the worse. I'll not have the sacrifices of my fallen brothers maligned to my face. You survived, Benmezda. Be thankful for that, if nothing else.
As you're about to address the paladin, the Red Prince interrupts and asks him if he's seen a lizard matching Brahmas's description. The paladin says that indeed he did, but that Brahmas left in a hurry when a band of rather intimidating-looking lizards showed up. One of the scouts saw him heading south in the direction of the graveyard. That's all he knows.
Right. I have the information I came for. He's all yours now.
A senior paladin sits hunched over a tattered map. He registers your presence, sits back in his chair, taps his fingers on the map.
I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. Who shall avenge you, darling one? I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. Who shall avenge you, darling one? I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. Who shall avenge you, darling one? I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. Who shall avenge you, darling one? I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. Who shall avenge you, darling one? shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. Who shall avenge you, darling one? I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. Who shall avenge you, darling one? I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping comes. Who shall avenge you, darling one? I shall not mourn till war is done. I shall not weep while blood still runs. I'll hold my tears when weeping.
Who are you and who sent you?
Who shall avenge you, darling one?
He looks up from his mat.
Who are you and who sent you?
He appraises you with a look, then grimly grins.
I think I've heard about you. Didn't you free the Meister from the gallows in Driftwood? Then I may well have a job for you, if you're interested.
He taps a finger on the map on the table.
Here, in the Black Pits, are White Magisters. Their operation is shrouded in mystery, and this pricks our ears. We are gravely concerned. We believe the White Magisters may have strayed into the darkness. We suspect that Dallas herself and her master, Vredeman, are the inspiration for these dark endeavors. Look under the... How much do you want? I have fewer paladins to pay, so I have ready gold. But there are limits. You think very highly of yourself, indeed.
He opens a pouch and shows you the contents. It's certainly an unreasonable sum, but it's not as outrageous as you might like.
Take it or leave it. Excellent!
He offers you an item. A whistle-like device sits nestled in your hand.
When you're ready, send a war owl. Be careful out there. It's a dangerous place these days. And I'd like to think I'll hear from you again. And, adventurer...
He looks you in the eye.
Don't get caught.
Four deer stand in formation near a crumbling altar. Three stags, fawn-colored and hearty, gaze cloudy-eyed at a great black skeleton glowing an eerie green. The four deer suddenly fall silent and stand stock still. The Voidwoken deer turns its head to you, great antlers glowing in the dappled shade.
Eat its eyes.
Thank you.
mine.
Look who's come to join the party. Oh, but you do get around, don't you?
He takes a satisfied sniff and rubs his hands together. His lips stretch into a mischievous smirk.
When it comes to graveyards, I'm a kid in a candy shop. All sorts of goodies and gewgaws for the taking. And a bit of rousing conversation. If you know where to dig, that is. Ah, it's a quandary, you see. I'm not exactly welcome in the Stone Garden. The servants attend the graves, well, their master, this Riker fellow, caught me nosing around, so he had them chase me off. The spirits within are particularly feisty as well. Can't say why, I'm as gentle as can be. Alas, I'm stuck sniffing out herbs and fungi on the outskirts.
He presses a forefinger against his chin and hums.
This is when having access to a Godwoken might come in handy. You see, beyond the gates, there's something that my heart, such as it is set on. Well, that's the gold-plated question it is. I dare say you'll enjoy this story. Somewhere in this graveyard lies an object of tremendous power. Or so the legends say, anyway. Belonged to a family buried near here, the Surreys. I've been reading up on them. An ancient clan of eccentrics and oddballs. Fascinating people, truly. Old Joanna was the last. The poor, poor, poor dear. Had no money, no children. Just this incredible heirloom passed down to her through the generations. Problem is, no one knows what this object is. Only that it's an astounding piece of work. Seems Joanna took its secrets to her grave. Rather literally.
His coy grin freezes.
I can recite each page from memory, but I've neither the time nor the inclination.
Tarquin sighs, and his lips unfreeze. For a moment, he looks almost modest.
It pains me to say, but you've talents in the adventuring department that I do not. This heirloom could prove valuable for both of us. Beautiful. The Surrey tomb must be somewhere nearby. And whatever that object is in there, I bet it's impressive.
He looks toward the graveyard.
I do wish I could wander inside. It would be nice to look up some old friends. See if they're in good spirits.